I greet everyone in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen. I thank God that we are all here today. And I feel so honored to stand before you to share the word of God with you. We are going to the word of God. We are going to read Ephesians chapter 2, verse 19 to 22.
Consequently, you are no longer foreigners and strangers, but fellow citizens with God's people, and also members of his household, built on the foundation of the apostles and prophets, with Christ Jesus himself as the chief cornerstone. In him the whole building is joined together and rises to become a holy temple in the Lord. And in him you too are being built together to become a dwelling in which God lives by his spirit.
Amen. Our topic today, it says, we are no longer foreigners. The word of God tells us here that you are no longer a foreigner or a stranger, but the fellow citizen with God's people and also the members of his household. We know that before Jesus Christ has died for us, we know that before our salvation, we were once separated from God. We were excluded from the citizenship in the kingdom of heaven. We were not counted. We were not partakers of his promises. In the very same chapter, in verse 13, it says, but now in Christ Jesus, you who once were far away have been brought near by the blood of Christ Jesus Christ. The word of God tells us that we are no longer foreigners. We are no longer strangers. But we are the fellow citizens of the kingdom of God. And we were brought near as we were far from God. As we were distanced. As we were no longer as we were not the partakers of the kingdom of God. But the blood of Jesus Christ came and washed us. And we became the partakers of the kingdom of God. Now we are seeing the importance of Jesus Christ for dying for our sins. Because now we partake in this kingdom. We partake in the promises of heaven. We partake in every decision of heaven. Glory be to Jesus. We were far, children of God. The sins were taking us far. We were far from God. As we all know that there's nothing that belongs to the kingdom of darkness will enter the kingdom of heaven. We know very well that our lives has no meanings. By that time, when we were still far from God, our life had no meanings. But when the blood of Jesus Christ washes us, washes the sins away, the iniquities and the transgression, we were brought near and we had hope. Everything that we lost, everything that has been stolen to us, from us, as the children of God, has returned to us. Because the blood of Jesus Christ draws us near to the kingdom of God. Draws us near to our Creator. We had no direction. We were wandering around. We were going there and there. Not knowing what we are doing. But we thank you. We thank you, Jesus. For the blood of Jesus. For his blood that was shed on the cross. I love the word of God when he says, he laid down his life for us. He had no sin. He was a lamb without blemish, but he took everything upon his shoulders. He died for us so that me and you, we can go back to our Creator. We are all the images of God. We are all the creators of God. We were created by God himself, by his own image. Remember Psalm 51, it says, in sin, my mother conceived me. We were conceived, we were born with sins. But the blood of Jesus was shed for me and you to be cleansed away. So now, as the citizen, as the partakers of the kingdom of God, we have to stay away from sins. We are no longer of the world. We are now the new creations. As the word of God of say, those who are in Christ Jesus, They are no longer the old creatures, but the new creatures. We are having a new life now. So we must stay away from the things of the world. We must stay away from the sins. Remember what the blood of Jesus has done. Through the blood of Jesus Christ, the barriers was broken. We were in the other level. We were in the other side. But when the blood of Jesus Christ came, it broke down the barriers. We came together with Jesus Christ. As we know that the word of God here says, with Christ Jesus himself as a chief cornerstone, in him, the whole building is joined together. We are joined together by Jesus Christ himself. We are one in him. We are no longer of that side of the kingdom of darkness. We are no longer lost. We are no longer wandering around. But we are in the citizenship of the kingdom of God. I love the word of God. Because it says, in him, you two are being built together to become a dwelling in which God lives by his spirit. We are the temples of God, where he lives by his own spirit. So it means we are no longer the partakers of those things, of the sins, of the, like, the senseless talks. What we do, we have to become that temple, that holding, that having the spirit of God inside. Even our talk must be different. Glory be to Jesus Christ. We are built on the strong foundations. We are built in a foundation that cannot be shaken. There's nothing that can shake us. Because the foundation that we are in is a strong foundation. The word of God says, we are built on the foundation of the apostles and the prophets. There's nothing of the world. There's nothing of darkness. There's no challenge, there's no problem that can shake us. Because we are the citizen of the kingdom of God. And we are built in this foundation, the foundation of Jesus Christ himself. We are the dwelling of the Spirit of God. We are chosen. Remember that Jesus Christ himself has trusted us to contain this kind of love, to contain the love, so that we'll be able to spread it all over around. Children of God, when we are saved, we are not saved for ourselves alone, but we are saved for the world. We are here as the partakers of the kingdom of God to show the people the light. The people must see the power and the glory of God through us. Nowadays, we are focusing on the things of the world. We are focusing on the material things. We forgot who we are. We mustn't forget who we are. We must remember that we are not the citizens of this earth, but the citizens of the kingdom of God. We are the citizens of heaven. So if our focus is in the things of the world, we are getting lost. Because if you gather the things for the world, we gather the material things for this world, what about your spiritual? What about your inner man? What about your soul? We mustn't concentrate all the things that we are seeing with our own eyes, but the things of heaven, where we are going to spend our eternity. Here we are just passing. In this earth we are passing. We are not here to stay forever. We are just here to stand for the kingdom of God. We are here, me and you, as now we are saved, to save other people's life. To go all over and share this gospel of God. To spread it. There are many people. There are lots of soul outside there. We must not forget that this salvation is not for us. Remember, we are always being taught by the men of God of saying, this grace is not for us only. We must spread it all over. In Africa, in the whole world, we must spread this gospel. Glory be to Jesus. We are joined together. Nothing will shake us. We are built together in Christ Jesus. We are one with him. Remember, we are built to become his dwelling, in which he lives by his own spirit. We are God's temple. Glory be to Jesus. Remember the word of God says, from being a foreigner to God's temple, to become his dwelling. We are no longer be controlled by the sinful nature, but we are controlled by the Spirit of God that lives in us. Glory be to Jesus. To God, we were like dead because of our sins. We were covered by our sins. But when the blood of Jesus Christ washes us, we became clean. We became brighter. We became the light. As the children of God, we now have new names. I don't know that before you were saved, what names were they calling you? But we thank Jesus because today we are called the children of God. We partake in his promises. We partake in his kingdom. We are given the new names through the blood of Jesus Christ. As foreigners, we didn't understand the language of God. Let's say you are the citizen of South Africa. You know all the rules. You know everything about the rules of South Africa, all the laws. So, but if you are a foreigner in the country, you don't understand what they do. You don't understand what should be followed. You must be taught. But we as the citizen of the kingdom of God, we know that our language is fire. We know the language and we understand the commandments of God. Remember that coming to church or being in a church doesn't mean that you are a citizen. You have to have the fellowship with God himself. Have the relationship with God so that we can become that citizenship. So that we may become the child of God. Maybe we got it wrong. Saying, I'm going to every Tuesday service. I'm going to Sunday service. I'm going to Wednesday service. That thing doesn't take everyone to heaven. What matters is the relationship that you have with God. As soon as we have that fellowship, as soon as we have that relationship with God, you become the citizen and you become the partaker of the kingdom of God. Glory be to Jesus. Being a partaker in the kingdom of God consists of all the God's promises. We become the heir of the kingdom of God. Children of God, you mustn't forget that we are the heir in the kingdom of God. We inherit all the promises. We are no longer strangers. We are no longer foreigners, but the citizen of the kingdom of God. We are the partakers of the kingdom of God. In the book of Psalms, the word of God says, he created everything with his own hand. And after that, he gave us the dominion. We dominate over everything that he created by his own hand. We mustn't forget that the kingdom that we are in is a powerful kingdom. The kingdom that we are in, it cannot be shaken. The foundation that we are built in cannot be shaken. We must not be scared by what the devil brings in our lives. Whatever the thing that comes in our lives, we must just see it as a test. When the sickness comes, you must take it as, this sickness is here in my life so that I can show, so that the world may see that the stripes of Jesus, by the stripes of Jesus Christ, I can be healed. There are some things that are happening in our lives so that the power and the glory of God can be revealed. All the things that we are facing, it doesn't mean that God is not there. He is there. We are just tested. We are tested so that we can be strong in our Christianity. If all your ways are smooth, how are we going to testify to the world? You cannot testify because you haven't faced any challenge. You haven't come across anything. But when you go through those things, you'll be able to testify. You'll be able to tell people how great is our God. Glory be to Jesus. We inherit in all the promise of God. We dominate over everything. We dominate over the challenges. We dominate over all the problems. We dominate over the sickness. We dominate over all the demons. There's no power of darkness that is above us. We have the power over everything. God has given us this power to dominate, to rule in other ways. To rule everything. There's no situation that can be above you. The situation must be under your feet. The challenges, you must walk over them. Remember that when Jesus Christ was here on earth, the word of God says he left us the example. We must walk over his footsteps. We must follow his footsteps. We must not be challenged by anything of the kingdom of darkness and that challenge win us over. Rather, we must win over that situation. We must win over the people of darkness to the kingdom of light. Hallelujah. In the kingdom of God, we are not treated as an outsider. Every decision in heaven includes us because we are the partakers. The partakers takes part. None of us has any idea of what God has planned for us. The word of God says, no eye has seen, no ear has heard, no mind has conceived what God has planned for his children. We must bear that in our mind. That the plan of God in our lives is so big. No one has any idea of what God has planned for us. We must stand still and know that he is God. We must not be shaken by anything. We mustn't allow the devil to come over our head. We must not allow the devil to grow fat in our family. We must not allow the devil to grow fat in our houses, in our children. He must know that we are the partakers of the kingdom of God. We are no longer foreigners, but the partakers. We are the citizens of the kingdom of God. He must know that we have the dominion over everything. He must know who we are. He must know that we are the children of fire. He must know that we mean business. Whatever that we talk comes to pass, and our Father stands for us. Glory be to Jesus. Let us read Ephesians chapter 5, verse 1 to 8.
Ephesians chapter 5, verse 1 to 8. Follow God's example. Therefore, as dearly loved children, and walk in the way of love, just as Christ loved us and gave himself up for us as a fragrant offering and sacrifice to God. But among you, there must not be even a hint of sexual immorality, or of any kind of impurity or of greed, because these are improper for God's holy people. Nor should there be obscenity, people. Nor should there be obscenity, foolish talk, or coarse joking, which are out of place, but rather thanksgiving. For of this you can be sure, no immoral, impure, or greedy person, such a person is an idolater, has any inheritance in the kingdom of Christ and of God. Let no one deceive you with empty words, for because of such things, God's wrath comes on those who are disobedient. Therefore, do not be partners with them. For you were once darkness, but now you are light in the Lord. Live as a children of light.
Amen. The word of God says, we were once in darkness, but now we are in the light. We are in the Lord. We must live as children of light. We ought to live a life full of love, as Jesus Christ did, by offering his own life for us. All Christians, as I said, We must walk on the footstep of Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ has showed us unconditional love by offering his own life for us. So we must also love one another. We must show the world the love. We must show this love to people. But by doing so, we must stay away from sins. The word of God here, it says, therefore, do not be partners with them. Do not be partners with the people that disobey God. We must stay away from the thing that is not pleasing God. We must stay away from the sinful nature. We must stay away from the impurity, the things that are not impure. We must stay away from the greed. We must stay away from the bitterness. We know very well that such kind of things doesn't please God. Our God hates sin. You cannot say you are the partaker in the kingdom of God while you are still sinning, while you are still following the things of darkness, while you are still following those people who are disobeying God. We don't want to see the wrath of God upon our lives. When you are saved, you took a step of saying, I want to be in this side, not the other side. So you must do the things of the kingdom of where we are. You must do everything that are doing in the kingdom that you are. We know very well that in the kingdom of God, there's no sin. There's no impurity. There's no anger. There's no lies. There's no gossip. Glory be to Jesus. The word of God says we must avoid evil talks, the foolish talks. You know, people are able to read us by what we are saying. If ever you are always talking the negative things, people can read you. How are we winning people to the kingdom of God while there are things that we are still talking? While we are still praising the things of darkness? Rather talk the things that will benefit other people. There's this word of saying, if you don't know what to say, keep quiet. Because as the children of God, we must talk things that gives life. We must speak life. We must speak the positive things. We must confess the good. Even if you are in the situation that is hard or the hardship, you must confess the good things. You must confess the positive. Because people are able to read us. Avoid the foolish talk. And talk the things that have sense. Talk life. Confess the positive. For people who live in sin, they can't inherit in the kingdom of God. If you are still living in your sins, if you are still living in your past, the past life that you used to live while you are still in the world, before you became saved, it means you cannot inherit in this kingdom. There is no impurity that will enter the kingdom of God. There's no accommodation, the accommodation of the sinners in the kingdom of God. Glory be to Jesus. Don't be deceived by darkness. Don't be deceived by the talks of darkness. Don't be deceived by the devil when he says you are not going anywhere. Remember that I said, nowadays we are focusing on the things of the world. We are focusing on getting cars. We are focusing on getting houses. We are focusing on getting marriages. But we forget about the kingdom of God. There are things that we can achieve. Remember the word of God says, seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all things will follow. If we seek the kingdom of God, if we seek his righteousness, if we seek his truth, everything that we need, it shall follow us. It will come to us. The sickness that you have, the problems, the hardship, God is able to solve them. That sickness, God is able to heal. But our focus must be on the things of heaven. We are passing. Remember how many times we were taught that Jesus Christ is coming. He's coming. And he wants to find us being ready. If we are not ready, you know, I once told myself that there are people that are watching us every day going to church. They are watching us when we carry the Bibles. They are watching us coming to Tuesday service and Sunday services. It's going to be painful if those people, we meet them at hell. We meet those people in hell, but we're telling ourselves that we are Christians. We must stay away from the things of darkness. We must not be deceived by the kingdom of darkness or by the lies of darkness. We know very well that the devil is a deceiver. We were once in darkness, but now we are in the light. Let this light that is in us expose the darkness. The light in us must expose the darkness. We must be the examples of our family. We must be example of the people that are around us. If there's darkness around you and you are the light, it means your light is not a true light. The word of God says, Jesus Christ, he says, I'm coming as a light to the world so that whoever follows me must not be in darkness. So my own life must benefit other people's life. I must be able to attract the darkness to the kingdom of light. The people around me, they must wish to be in this salvation because of my own life. Our deeds and our ways must testify that you are in the light. If your works doesn't testify that you are in the light, there's something that you must go and fix. You must go back and check your own life. You must go back and check your Christianity. Glory be to Jesus. Our deeds and our ways must testify that we are in the light. We must seek the things that are pleasing before God. We must have nothing to do with the things of darkness. The word of God in 1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 12. It says, we must not allow people to look us down, but we must be the examples in our speech, in our life, in loving each other, in faith and in purity. As the partakers and the citizen of the kingdom of heaven, we must be the example in our speech, the way we talk. You know, the way we talk determines who you are. Our speech must show, must tell that we are in the kingdom of heaven, that we are in the kingdom of light. Our lives must show that we are in Christ Jesus. People must rate the way we live. Your own family must see the change in you because you are no longer the old person. Your life must tell them. Even if they don't see the material things, but they must see a change in you. If you used to be angry, if you used to insult people, they must see that no, there's something changed in this person. Where you are staying, your neighbors. You know, we Christian, we intend to say, we intend not to care about other people. We intend to be ignorant in a way that you find a Christian, he doesn't talk to the neighbors. They are the people that you are staying with. You don't even greet them because you think, oh no, this is the people of the world. I don't have anything to do with them. Remember that we are here to win those people to the kingdom of God. We must know that loving other people or showing them love will be able to win them. You know, you find, let's say as a tenant, there are people who may need help, who may need prayer, but they cannot approach you because you can, when people look at you by your facial expression, they are just scared. We must love each other. We must show people love. When people see us, they must see the solution. When the people see us, they must see the power of God. When the people see us, they must see the love of God. Glory be to Jesus. In faith, the way we handle challenges, people must see that our foundation is in Jesus Christ. Our faith must tell. You know, when you are sick, people are asking you, how do you feel? You don't confess the healing. You always confess, hey, I know it's hard. It's getting worse and worse. Our faith must tell that we are in the kingdom of light. Our faith must tell that we are founded in Jesus Christ. Our faith must tell that we are in the kingdom of light. We are the partakers. We are the citizen of the kingdom of God. We must confess the positive. We must tell the people that even if I'm in this situation, Jesus Christ is the Lord. Glory be to Jesus. In purity, remember that the word of God says, be holy because God is holy. If you are not living a holy life, what are you saying to the world? We must live in purity. We must set the good example. We must show people that in the kingdom of God, there's purity. If you are a Christian, you are still associating yourself with the people that are disobeying God. You are not in purity. Be pure as God is pure. Remember that we used to have friends. Those maybe we are going to the party with. They must know that now I'm living a pure life. Now I'm living a holy life. Because I'm now in the different kingdom. I'm now in God. Our life must tell that my life is pure. If you're still going to those parties but telling yourself that you are a Christian, no, you're not living a pure life. There are the things that we must remove ourselves from. We must think, there are things that we must stay away from as the children of God. Respect and humbleness. We don't live like fools, but we live like the wise. Remember, the kingdom of God is not of the fools, but of the wise. We must respect other people. We must respect each other. We must be humble. We know very well that the spirit of pride comes from the kingdom of darkness. If you still have pride, but you are saying you are the partaker of the kingdom of God, no, you are not. The thing of the pride is of the kingdom of darkness. Respect, humbleness, patience. Those are the things of the kingdom of God. Those are the things that shows us that we are the partakers of the kingdom of God. We must use every opportunity we are given by God. Let us make every second, every minute to count. As we are the citizen of the kingdom of God, we must use every opportunity we are given by God. Check that, what am I doing with my time? If I'm not reading the word of God, or if I'm not praying, what am I doing? Are we wasting our times by gossiping? Are we wasting our times by worrying? Are we wasting our times by backstabbing other people? We must acknowledge the time that we are given in this earth, because we are about to go home. Understand the will of God in your life. As Christians, we must know our positions and understand who we are. And that thing will help us to live the life that God wants us to live. If you understand who you are in the kingdom of God, if you understand who you are, if you understand your Christianity, you'll be able to hold this way. You will walk in the ways of God. You will follow his commandments. You will do according to his word. Glory be to Jesus. We must know our positions. We mustn't forget who we are. We mustn't forget our positions. We mustn't forget that we are the royal priest of the kingdom of God. We mustn't forget that our life has been changed. We mustn't forget that we are in a foundation that cannot be shaken. We are in the kingdom of light. We are in the kingdom of power. Glory be to Jesus. Let us read Galatians chapter 5, verse 22.
Galatians 5, 22. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, forbearance, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Against such things, there is no law.
Amen. The word of God says this is the fruit of the Spirit. Remember in Ephesians, where we read in Ephesians 2, they say, the word of God says, God has made us the dwelling where he lives by his own Spirit. So, the fruit of the Spirit is love. If you don't have love, you are still lacking. Joy, peace, gentleness, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, self-control. We must be able to control ourselves. We must be able to have love, the joy in us. We are able, you know, we are able to conquer the temptation. We don't feed the flesh. The desire of the flesh, we overcome them. Because now we are the dwelling of the Spirit of God. We are the temple of the Holy Spirit. Our bodies doesn't contain the demons, doesn't contain the sins, but it contains the love. It contains the fruit of the Spirit. It contains the Holy Spirit. The fruit of the Spirit. They're talking about peace. Remember that when you have this peace in you, when there's a family conflict in your family, you are the one who can bring this peace in your family. Rather making things worse. We are here to bring peace. We are here to bring peace to the world. Glory be to Jesus. Self-control. Faithfulness. If you are still failing to be faithful, there's something that is still shorting in your life. We must be faithful. We must be able to tell the truth in everything that we do. We must stay away from the things that lead us to the sins. We must concentrate on the things that is taking us to the kingdom of God. Glory be to Jesus. We must develop this fruit of the Spirit. Let us read Romans chapter 12, verse 20 to 21. Romans chapter 12, verse 20 to 21.
Romans chapter 12, verse 20 to 21. On the contrary, if your enemy is hungry, feed him. If he is thirsty, give him something to drink. In doing this, you will heap burning coals and on his head. Do not be overcome by evil, but overcome evil with good.
We must continue doing the good. We must not get weary of doing good things. The word of God says, if your enemy is hungry, feed him. If he's thirsty, give him something to drink. In doing things, you will heap burning coals on his head. By doing good, you overcome the evil. We shame the devil by doing good. Every time when you do a good thing, by feeding the people that are against us, by giving them something to drink, we are overcoming the devil. Remember that the war is not for us, but for God. Leave the revenge to God. We don't fight for our own battles. We leave everything unto God. We feed them. We give them something to drink. And by doing that, we overcome the devil. Glory be to Jesus. In Galatians chapter 6, verse 9, the word of God says, let us not become weary in doing good, for at a proper time, we will reap a harvest if we don't give up. Continue to do the good things. Continue to feed the enemy. Continue to give them something to drink. Continue to show the people love. Because our reward is not on the people. Our reward is not of the world. But we know that we'll harvest the reward in heaven. Remember that the main purpose of God is to win all his children back to his kingdom. So when we feed our enemies, when we give them something to drink, when we show them love, we win them back to the kingdom of God. Those people, they are stolen by darkness, as you and me, we were being stolen by darkness. We were stolen, but now we are drawn back to Jesus Christ, to God himself. So we must always remember that God wants to win his people back to his kingdom. People must see the importance of Christianity through us. You know, when you show your enemy the love, the word of God says, you'll heap a burning coal on his head. You give them something to talk about. You give them question and say, you know what, I've been witching these people. I've been doing 1, 2, 3 on this person. But this person is showing me love. This person is giving me something to eat. Is giving me something to drink. And at the end of the day, is when people will come and say, how are you doing it? Just tell us the formula. Because we've been doing 1, 2, 3. They'll come and confess to you. When they come and confess, is when you'll tell them that, you know what, I'm able to do this because I've got Jesus Christ in my life. And they will follow you. Glory be to Jesus. The word of God says, we are God's fellow worker. We are his field and we are his building. The field is where people are planting the seeds. God has trusted us in this earth to spread this gospel, to spread this seed of the word of God. So as we are his fellow worker, as we are his field, and as we are his building, we must show this to the world. Glory be to Jesus. Remember, I said, the men of God usually always tell us that the grace is not for us alone. The salvation is not for us alone. The word of God says, we are saved by his grace. So let this grace of salvation spread all over the world. In 2 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 2 to 3, the word of God says, we are the newsletter of God. People must be able to read us. As the newsletter, we must be readable. Our own life, our own deeds must confirm, must say, must talk for us. As the newsletter, our life must testify the glory of the kingdom of God. You know, children of God, you must be readable. People must see the glory, the power of God through our lives. I'd rather be rich towards God or in the things of God than in material things. We must be readable by the world. We must love one another. You must not be easily offended. You must not be bitter. When the people talk negative about you, you must not be offended. Because you don't know what they are seeing in you. You must not be provoked by what people are saying about you. You might be coming here to the church and people are seeing you, you are still limping. When the people asking you, where's your God? You must not be offended. You must always be positive in everything. Whether you see healing, whether you see prosperity, whether you see this, whether you are not seeing them or you see them, God is still the same. Remember that God is not changed by the weather. His love endures forever. He's always loving. He's always compassionate. He's still the same God. Remember that the light cannot be defeated by darkness. Do not allow your light to be defeated by darkness. Because we know that when it becomes the night, when you switch on the light, or when the light comes, the darkness disappears. The kingdom of God cannot be silenced by the kingdom of darkness. We mustn't allow the devil to talk above the things of God. The voice of God must not be louder. We've been taught that the devil is rubbish, is foolish, is stupid. So how are we going to allow his voice to be upon us, to be louder than the voice of God? We rather hear the voice of God than hearing the voice of devil. Because we know that whatever that he's whispering is rubbish. And everything that he's talking is worthless. We must know the qualities we have in God. Children of God, the man of God always telling us that we have the weight of Jesus Christ. We must know the qualities as the children of God. The word of God in 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verse 20, it says, we are the ambassadors of the kingdom of God. The true ambassadors. We are here to represent the kingdom of God. Give thanks in all circumstances. Hold on doing good. Avoid the evil. Remember the word of God in Matthew chapter 13 verse 43. The word of God says, the righteous will shine like the sun in the kingdom of the Father. Everything that we do, we are doing it to shine in the kingdom of our Father. We are doing it to inherit, to get the crown, to reign with Jesus Christ. We will shine in the kingdom of our Father. Let us keep on doing the righteous things. Let us keep on of being the righteous of God. Let us keep this status of being the righteous of God, of being the partakers. Let us continue to hate the devil. In Philippians chapter 3 verse 14, we can read it. Philippians chapter 3 verse 14.
I press on toward the goal to win the prize for which God has called me heavenward in Christ Jesus.
Our goals is not on the things of the earth. We must press on. We must continue to run this race. We must press on. We must look unto the goal of getting the crown in heaven, of reigning with Jesus Christ. We must press on to win the prize. Glory be to Jesus. I press on towards the goal to win the prize of which God has called me heavenward in Christ Jesus. Let us not get weary. Let us not get tired. Let us press on. Let us run this race. Let us go forward. Let us follow this way of God and reject the ways of darkness. The word of God in 2 Corinthians chapter 4 verse 18. It says, so we fix our eyes not on what is seen, but on what is unseen. Since what is seen is temporary, but what is unseen is eternal. The things that we are seeing with our eyes, the things that we desire on this earth, the material things that we are seeing, they are for temporary. But if you focus on the things of heaven, if you focus on where we are going to spend our eternity, we mustn't focus on the things of earth. Our eyes must always look up. Glory be to Jesus. In this earth, we are only here to represent the kingdom of God. Psalm 37 verse 27 is said, turn from evil and do good. Then you will dwell in the land forever. If you turn from evil and you continue to do good, then you will dwell in the land forever. You will continue to be the partaker, the inheritance of the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. In Psalm chapter 34 verse 17, it says, the righteous cry out and the Lord hears them. He delivers them from all their troubles. The Lord is close to the heartbroken and saves those who are crushed in spirit. The righteous person may have many troubles, but the Lord delivers him from them all. He protects all his bones. Not one of them will be broken. If we cry out as the righteous of God, he hears us. He delivers us from all the troubles. So we mustn't worry about our troubles. If you are heartbroken, God is close to us. And he saves us as we are crushed in the spirit. Let us continue to be clean. Let us continue to keep ourselves clean so that we can be a clean dwelling place of the Spirit of God. The word of God says the righteous person may have many troubles, but the Lord delivers him from them. Every trouble that you are facing, God is able to deliver you from them. Every situation that you are in, God is able to pull you out. Every sickness that you are having, God is able to heal you. Glory be to Jesus. Glory be to Jesus. Let us hold on into this journey. Let us run this race. Let us pressing on the goal of winning the prize, of getting the crown in heaven, of reigning with Jesus Christ forever. We cannot be the strangers in the kingdom of our Father. Unless if you are not yet saved. But if you are saved, you cannot be a stranger. You cannot be a foreigner. But you are the fellow citizen. You are the partaker. You are the dwelling place of the kingdom of God.